this is it. This is life, the one you get. Chuckle and have a ball. This is it.
Norman, you deserve all the awards, every single one of them. Congratulations on this incredible award. I love you. I love your integrity. I love your dignity. I love your enthusiasm. I love your generosity. I love working with you. I love talking to you. One of my greatest memories is running to you after I would do a scene and you'd be behind the monitor and just to see what you thought of something that I was doing. Norman Lear, one of the greatest things that's happened to me in this life is becoming your friend. Congratulations, my wonderful, beautiful, dear friend. I love you.
Norman Lear. You guys know that cliche that people say they broke the mold when they made this person. Well, I think the only person it might actually apply to is Norman Lear. There is nobody else like him. I remember season one or two, there had been a birthday on set, so there was cake. And we were doing the live show, the audience was there, and I wanted some cake because I wasn't in that scene. And so I had this huge heavy plate and cake, and I stood next to Norman and I was eating it. And he looked at me and he said, "Let me hold it for you." And I was like, "Oh, Mr. Lear, it's okay, like I'm good." And he was like, "Please." And this man proceeded to hold my plate of birthday cake for me so that I could eat off of it and have a hands-free experience. And we just watched the scenes like that and sat in front of the audience and ate and chatted for a while. And that's the kind of person that Norman is. When you meet him, you would never know that he is this legend that has changed so many people's lives, that has changed so many narratives, that has done so much for the world. He's consistently kind and humble and so genuinely curious about the person who is sitting across from him. And that's the best thing about him. He is one of the best people, if not the best person I've ever met. And maybe there wasn't even a mold. I think Norman is one of a kind, and there was nobody else like him before, and there will be nobody else like him again.
Norman Lear. The fact that I can even say Norman Lear like we're pals, because we're pals, is crazy to me. Still is crazy to me that I can just like text you or call you. I should do that more. Okay, Norman Lear. Congratulations. Congratulations on getting your 100,000th award. The thing is, you deserve all of them. You should get all of the awards because you deserve all of them. To say that I love you is an understatement because what you've done for humanity since being on this planet, not to mention what you've done for me. I know I've tried to compliment you before and thank you for changing my life. And you're always so like, "Oh, Gloria." but you did. You changed people's lives. Not only because you're so truly curious, you're so truly interested in our common humanity, but you also really see people. You see people, Norman. And you saw me and all of the people that love you. You saw us when other people didn't. And I can't tell you how impactful that is. I can't tell you what it does to be seen by you. It really shifts something inside. It shifts something. And not only does it shift something internally, but it to have somebody with your reputation and with your taste sort of bless us means that other people also have permission to see us. So thank you for being who you are, which is a loving and kind person that wants very much to use the power of this incredible business that we're in, this incredible medium that we use to connect, to build bridges, to find a common understanding. I'm just so blessed that I got to be on this planet at the same time as you, and that somewhere along the way you plucked me from obscurity and left indelible marks on me, because I cherish those marks. I cherish the little Norman touch. So congratulations on this wonderful award. Congratulations on everything that you do every single day, because it just makes the world a better place. I love you very much. Congrats.
Norman, hey, I am so sorry. Hold on. Oh, okay. Whew, sorry. Norman, congratulations on the Carol Burnett Award. What an incredible achievement. I find it hard to believe you don't have all the awards yet, but for some reason you don't have this one, and so congratulations. You are television. That's all there is to it. I grew up, it's such an incredible honor and learning experience to have been able to spend these last 5 years with you on One Day at a Time, just being mentored by you, learning from you. Honestly, I consider it my greatest achievement that I, along with Gloria Calderon-Kellett, did not destroy your legacy. You know, this, I mean, if you think about it, let's just game it out. I mean, this could have gone a whole different way. Like, you know, the show could have come out, and then maybe it sucks, and then suddenly, I mean, then are you getting the Carol Burnett Award at that point? I mean, just kind of a, maybe not. Maybe it's, you know, maybe you're sitting home and, I don't want to bring everybody down. I'm just saying, do I deserve credit for, no, this, did I do this for you? No, obviously you had some television before this. I can't think of anything right now, but I feel like you did some shows. I got to think about some stuff. Anyway, congratulations on the Carol Burnett Award from your mentor.
Congratulations, Norman. The Golden Globes, the Carol Burnett Award. Come on. This is amazing. You deserve all of it. All of the awards, all the time. Thank you, man. Thank you for making my life infinitely better through all of the love and laughter that you've put in it. Thank you for changing TV and this country and the world. You've made all of us and this place immeasurably better just by being you. I'm so grateful to know you. You're my hero, and I'm proud to call you my friend too. So I love you, man, and congratulations.
Hey, Norman, I hear you keep raising the bar. Want to congratulate you on receiving the Carol Burnett Award at this year's Golden Globes. Couldn't be more thankful to know you and be able to call you family. I miss you a lot and hope to see you soon. Congrats, Norman. Super proud.
Hi, this is Stephen Tobolowsky, and it's easy to say something in honor of Norman Lear. He's been one of the most important people in my life two different ways, personally, professionally. Personally, I grew up in Oak Cliff, which is a small township outside of Dallas, Texas, about 20 miles from downtown. Oak Cliff was what you call a white flight area. A lot of nice people in Oak Cliff, but it was a township of great exclusion. And as a young boy, I saw that there was a current of meanness that operated underneath the surface. And I'm always thinking, there's got to be something wrong with this picture. And then I saw All in the Family on TV. And then I saw The Jeffersons. Then One Day at a Time and Maude. And Norman Lear's television shows became the real window to my world. And I began to see the way the world really works. I saw that people don't want to change. And that could be funny. And then I saw that when those people try to change, that could be even funnier. Norman Lear taught me, not with lectures, but with laughter, of how the world could be. Now that's personal. Professionally, I mean, one in a million shot. The first professional job I ever got in Los Angeles was an extra on Mary Hartman, Mary Hartman. First week I came out to LA. The first television show I ever saw live was One Day at a Time with Bonnie Franklin, because Kay Callan, a girl from my township of Oak Cliff, had a part on it. And she invited me to see the show and meet the man, Norman Lear. And then, of course, One Day at a Time, the remake. Such a pleasure working with Norman every week. This man has changed my life in so many ways, and always with laughter. Congratulations, Norman, and much love.
Hey, Norman, we just got off the phone with each other and we were talking about this weekend and that you're going to be receiving the Carol Burnett Lifetime Achievement Award at the Golden Globes. What I didn't tell you is that after we hung up, I'd be recording this video with the One Day at a Time family, congratulating you on that very honor. And I found it rather fitting and somewhat romantic that it was the One Day at a Time family that decided to put this video together, because at the end of the day, it was the One Day at a Time family that I think rebooted Norman Lear back into television again to let everybody know that you're still very much here. And this year marks our 14th year working together, which is even hard for me to say. I can't believe that we've had 14 years together, but I can tell you they've been the best 14 of my life, and I am really excited to see what the next 14 bring. I congratulate you on this honor for this weekend. I'm glad that it took 98 and a half years for the Hollywood Foreign Press Association to realize that you are deserving of this award. Love you, Norman.
Norman, you precious, precious human being. The words that come to mind are thought-provoking, innovative, way ahead of the times, and that includes this very minute. Provocative, bold, original. And what a joy and an honor to know you. And more than that, to know that we share a love child. Moshe, come over here. Moshe. Oh, he's playing with love. I love you.